Hello, I'm Franz Zischka, owner of SysConsult Engineering in Germany. During my career as application engineer for ICAP, I observed modeling engineers around the world doing similar things when they do modeling. I saw that sometimes they can end up with many mouse clicks and other operations to perform their modeling tasks. But what they need is an easy access to plots that display measurement and simulation data. They need quick access to tuning and optimization of parameters. And they need a simple tool to compare the current modeling state with previous ones. But guess what? ICAP also offers incredible programming tools. And so over time, I developed my own simplified user interface for recurring modeling tasks. It has become my main tool when working with ICAP. And so I feel it's really something worth sharing with you. I do hope that with this open source tool, you will become more efficient in generating highly accurate models. Let me now show you how it works. It presents your selection of plots required for a specific modeling task, your selection of the corresponding model parameters, buttons for manual tuning or optimization, and furthermore, you can even monitor the history of your modeling steps. This user interface has been written model independently, and so it can be applied to all kinds of models and to all kinds of data, be it DC, CV, S parameters, noise, time domain, and so on. The entire tool, including all the macros and features, resides in a separate ICAP model file, which I call utilities, and which you can automatically load when starting ICAP. It hosts my best practice macro programs, which are all open source and well documented. The simplified user interface, which I want to demonstrate to you today, is located in DUT Modeling GUI. It hosts the setup General Modeling GUI, and in this setup, on the Extract Optimize tab, you see a list of programs which ICAP calls transforms. All of them are like subprograms to the main program, which is named Start Modeling GUI. And this is the program which will be called from your own model file. But I will provide more details on this later. Let me now demonstrate all this with a simple modeling example, the modeling of a Zener diode in the DC forward and in the reverse range. And so I load the model file Z diode modeling, which is also included in the download material. I open the file with the left mouse double click. And, shown on the left side of the window, is the structure of the modeling flow. After a quick initialization, the DC forward and reverse modeling is performed, followed by an optional model stability check related to extended DC bias and temperature simulations. However, due to limited time, this stability check is not covered by this video, but described in details in the download material. Finally, the optimized model is saved to a spy stack. But let's now go step by step. In the setup initialize, the transforms set project name, define working directory, and reset modeling are used to configure the project environment and reset the model parameters. We are now ready to start the DC modeling, and I can show you now the simplified user interface, the main topic of this video. In DUT DC modeling, I select the setup forward, and then transform do modeling. This transform contains the function call to the simplified user interface located in the preloaded utilities file, as mentioned before. All I need to do here is to define two variables. One is called plots and the other one is called parameters. After clicking the execute button, I get this window. In red, we have the measured data and in blue, the simulated data from the model. Since no fitting has occurred yet, we see a significant gap between the two. And what do we get now in this GUI? Do you remember the code from the Do Modeling program? The plot logger AVA is immediately shown, and the linear plot, marked by a comment sign in variable plots, is available in the GUI for being selected upon request. The model parameters IS, N and RS are displayed and ready for use as are defined by variable parameters. Let me now start the demo. I begin by selecting the diode parameters IS and click the Tune button to fit the curve. Once I got a reasonably good fit, I click on the OK button. Next, I select RS and now tune to get close to the ohmic range of the measured data. When done, I click OK. At this point, we can fine-tune the model parameters using the optimizer. With the left mouse pushed down, I define the fitting region and hit the R key on my keyboard to make it the blue optimizer target box as usual in ICCAP. Then I select all three parameters and hit Optimize. With a single click, I can add also the linear plot and check the fit there too. I define a blue target box on this additional plot and optimize once again. Now the fit is really quite good, isn't it? And I achieved it with a single user interface and with a minimum of mouse clicks. We could now inspect the evolution of the parameter values during the current modeling step by selecting the button Show Model Parameter Evolution. On the left are our starting parameter values and to the right the final ones. The values seem to have converged and so I hit OK to return to the main GUI. Here I can also recapitulate our modeling steps. This was our starting point. This was the result after the manual tuning, after the first optimization and after the last one. If not satisfied, I could also step back and apply another modeling strategy. But for this demo, I hit OK, done and close the window and we are back in our model file. Moving further down the transform flow, I execute save modeling state to save the current status of the model and its parameters for later reference. The next step is the DC reverse modeling, which is important to fit well, since this mode is the most commonly used application of a Zener diode. I select Setup Reverse and execute Transform Do Modeling. We see the same custom UI now aimed at modeling the reverse bias region and showing the reverse breakdown parameter BV. Like before, we had specified this plot and parameter by the two variables in the calling transform. I tune the breakdown voltage parameter BV to fit the reverse Zener voltage. I then optimize the fitting in the blue marked Zener range. Well, the measured data shows significantly more leakage current before the Zener voltage, and this cannot be fitted with the simple bias model we have used so far, and so we need to improve the underlying model. I hit OK to close this window and execute the transform save modeling state to save the current model status and its parameters. Let me now show you how we can improve the model netlist and still leverage the same modeling UI and even switch between the two netlist versions. Going to the circuit tab, we see the SPICE netlist and I enhance the simple diode model used so far with a subcircuit featuring a second diode, connected in parallel but reversed to the primary diode D-main. I go back to setup reverse and re-execute do modeling. The parameters of the added reverse diode have not yet been defined at startup and therefore I click Add Parameters and select the S and N of the new introduced reverse diode. I do a manual tuning followed by a fitting box optimization. Well, this looks a lot better and so I hit OK to close the window. And like before, I execute transform save modeling state. I can now review and compare the fitting results for all my modeling steps by executing the transform compare with previous. In this window, all modeling states saved by transform save modeling state of the current setup are shown by default. But I also have the option show all MPS files. And this allows to monitor our modeling progress right from the beginning. The first entry shows our DC forward result, then comes the reverse modeling with the single diode model, and finally the modeling with both, the forward and the reverse diode. Everything looks okay and I complete my modeling by saving the SPICE deck with my fitted parameter values. This ends my demo, where we accomplished many useful steps in model fitting via the simplicity of a simplified user interface. And please note again that no programming was required. I hope that you are as excited as I am about this simplified user interface, and I invite you to try it out in your own modeling project. Simply copy-paste the corresponding transform into your project, and that's all. So, please click the link to download the ICCAD model files and the documentation. Thank you, and don't hesitate to contact Keysight Technologies for more information.